On this special Christmas episode of Supercars Talk, Lee Holdsworth finds himself a full-time seat for next year, and Matt Payne will be doing Super 2. Big news this week. The Bend is back. The TBA on the calendar, July 30th, 31st, will be filled by the Bend. That's good news, except still no 500 warm-up to Bathurst. So that's a little bit disappointing, but at least now we know what that TBA is, and we will be going back to South Australia. So you guys down in Adelaide will not miss out next year. It has been announced that Matt Payne will be doing Super 2 next year. They're not going to try and get some dispensation. They probably figured they weren't going to get it. So they're going to run a two-car program in Super 2 by the sounds of things, with Matt Payne leading that. And Lee Holdsworth, your Bathurst winner, will be taking the now number 10 seat at Grove Racing next year. That is the last seat to be filled. I keep saying that because there's question marks over the techno guys, of course. Is this the right move for Lee? He could have continued with Chaz at Bathurst. You're probably not going to have the same thing again next year where you are unquestionably the fastest car, but, you know, does he want to go and bang his head against the wall all year to finish around the back half of the field? The Groves are headed in the right direction, probably. I mean, they've got Couchy coming in and things like that, but he's not going to be until middle of the year, so you're not going to see the differences he's going to make until really Gen 3 stuff. And then is Lee, he'll be there on a one-year deal. Is he going to be around the year after, or will Matt Payne kind of walk into that? I mean, I could eat my words pretty soon, but I wouldn't have recommended that move for him. Lots of comments I saw on the internet about, oh, it's good to have someone in there that'll push Reynolds. Well, what was Jaime doing all last year? I mean, yeah. What was probably more interesting was that they used Reynolds' car with all the Penrite sponsorship on there for all the promo shots and that, and wearing Penrite gear and that. No sign of Ned anywhere. So will it be a two-car Penrite team? They did say something about, oh, they just did that because that's what they had lying around. But it just seems a bit strange because both cars would have been there, and I can't see why you wouldn't still have the Ned one mocked up if that's what was happening. So that's probably the bigger question there, is whether it will be two Penrite cars or if we will see Ned back or not. The last bit of news for the year is that every team is going to have a seat on the new Supercars Commission or whatever. It has probably been a little bit unfair that not every team has had representation on the commission, but also I think possibly that maybe no team should have a part of the decision making, because there does seem to be a lot of vested interest going in. I suppose it takes away some of the vested interests that we have had, because then everybody's involved, but then everybody's involved, so it'll make it even harder to get a decision made. I still think you need, like what F1 used to have, one dictator makes a decision, and like it or lump it, that's what it is. If you don't like it, well, you know, go and play lawn bowls, or you just put up with it. That's what my opinion is anyway. So this is the final episode for the year. I'm going to call this my Christmas special because it's coming out on Christmas Eve. This is the 72nd and final episode for the year. So I was pretty impressed when I counted it up. A lot of episodes. Bit of a milestone this year for the channel. Over 1,000 subscribers. We had a big pickup around the start of the year, up to 1,750 odd subscribers now. So thank you everybody for watching. Some very special things that happened during the year. Obviously, the big one was I got to interview Glenn Seaton. So that was really, really, really special. I did also get to meet, I suppose, a podcasting icon of mine, Richard Spanners Reddy. I got to talk to Jonathan Simon as well. He was brilliant. He gave me a few little tips and things like that as well. Thank you very much to those guys. It just kind of levels me up a little bit. And I also got to catch up with some old friends, that slot car guy, Evan Hocking and Broomy. It was great, even though those videos did not rate very well. It was great fun catching up with you guys over the COVID break, where, you know, especially in Melbourne, we didn't get to see people for so long. So yeah, there was a lot of, you know, catching up with people on Zoom. So it was good to be able to, you know, do something with it. I did get my logo on a supercar, a V8 supercar. Wasn't, you know, one of the race cars that we talk about, but one of the big fans of the channel, Big Wheel Racing, he did get on the front bumper, put my little logo on there. That was very special. I'll put a photo on there. Blown away, little things like that. It means so much. Next year, I have got plans for some on-track kind of activities. Should be able to get to some races, and as long as the team that has kind of, you know, offered me some stuff, as long as they're not too pissed off with how I've, you know, ranked their drivers and been a bit critical of certain decisions and that over the year, so as long as we're still going, yeah, we should be right to do some stuff at the track. So really looking forward to that. But thank you everyone for watching all year. Thank you for all your comments and everything. I try to reply to everyone. It's just been really great. Hope you all have a really good break. I'll be back in a couple of weeks, hopefully with some new and exciting content for you. Even with all of this, I'm still having trouble to speak. So until next time, I'm still Dave, and I'll catch you later.